Hi student, till now we have discussed in our chapter aesthetics about mean, then mode and median. We have discussed about to calculate the all three measures of center tendency to calculate by using discrete series and by how can we calculate by using this formula for any group data there. Now look, using all methods to find out our mean, mode, median. Now one of the question is arises there if there is any relationship between this mean, mode and median, then our answer should be yes. The relationship between this known is known as a empirical relations. We are going to discuss today empirical relations among our three measures, means our mean, mode and median. Today in this class we are going to discuss the empirical relationship in our amongst our three measures, which are our central values there gives, then it's our mean, mode and median. Now look, when we are going to talk about relationship between mean, mode and median, then the relationship, it depends on frequency distribution. The relationship between this mean, mode and median is or depends on upon the nature of our frequency distribution. What is the nature of frequency distribution? When we are going to discuss the nature of frequency distribution, then it's having two natures. One is a symmetrical, it's having a symmetrical nature there. And second one is a asymmetrical nature. What is our nature of frequency distribution? It's our symmetrical or it's a asymmetrical. Then when our distribution, frequency distribution symmetrical there, in this case our mean, mode and median are identical. Understand what I want to say that? Yes. In the case when our frequency distribution is symmetrical, then in this case our mean, mode and median, all three are identical. What is meaning of all three are identical? Means these three are having the same value. When our frequency distribution in a symmetrical distribution there, in case mean, mode, median are identical, that is the have the same values. When the it is a case of our frequency distribution is our asymmetrical, means it's also termed as a skewed. When our frequency distribution is skewed, means it's our asymmetrical. It means our distribution is lie about mode to the left or right to the mode there. In such cases, when we are going to find out the relationship between these three measures of centered values, then what we get, it's having a relationship in our asymmetrical cases. What is the relationship between these three? Are our mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mode. Sorry. Our mode is given by mode is 3 median minus 2 mean. Our mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean. What is the relation between our mode? Our mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean. This is our empirical, this is called our empirical relationship. This is our empirical formula. This is our empirical relationship in amongst mode, median and mean. Our mode is calculated by 3 times median minus 2 mean. 3 times median minus 2 mean. It means if we know the values of any two measures, then we can find out, then we can calculate the values of our third measure here. Then look up. अभी हमने यहाँ पे एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला पढ़ा, जहाँ जो हमारी रिलेशनशिप देती है मीन मोड और मीडियन के बीच। और एक्चुअली लुक, जो हमारी रिलेशनशिप है मीन मोड और मीडियन की, वो डिपेंड्स करती है फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के नेचर पे, कि हमारा फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का नेचर कैसा है। फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के नेचर की बात करते हैं तो इसके दो तरह के नेचर होती है। एक होती है हमारी सिमेट्रिकल फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, दूसरी होती है असिमेट्रिकल, आल्सो टर्म्स इज स्क्यूड सिमेट्रिकल, स्क्यूड इन द टर्म्स ऑफ स्क्यूड देयर। जब हमारा फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन क्या होता है, आपका सिमेट्रिकल होता है, मतलब एक समान रूप से फैला होता है, एक समान एक किसी भी अबाउट आपका जो मेजर्स के सेंटर वैल्यूज उसके एक समान हो, अगर वो हमारा डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिमेट्रिकल रूप से फैला हुआ है, तो उस केस में जब हम एक ही पॉइंट पे जो भी हमारा फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ग्राफ होगा, कर्व होगा, उस केस में हमारा मीन मोड और मीडियन क्या होते हैं, वो आइडेंटिकल होते हैं। मीन्स आपका एक इनकी जो वैल्यूज होती है वो सेम होती है। पर जब बात करते हैं हमारी दूसरी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के दूसरे वो केस, वो जब हमारा जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का जो नेचर है वो सिमेट्रिक ना हो के असिमेट्रिक हो या स्क्यूड हो, उस केस में जो हमारा रिलेशनशिप है इन तीनों मेजर्स ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंथ, जो सेंट्रल वैल्यूज मेजर्स हमारे हैं मीन मोड और मीडियन, इट्स गिवन बाय आवर मोड इज गिवन बाय इक्वल टू 3 मीडियन माइनस 2 मीन। अब हमारे पास इसके वी कैन यूज एट्स कैलकुलेट एनी, इफ यू हैव एनी टू मेजर्स देयर देन वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट इजली आवर थर्ड मेजर, वी कैन गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट आवर थर्ड मेजर। देन लुक, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टेक सम प्रॉब्लम्स विच आर बेस्ड ऑन आवर एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला ऑफ मोड मीडियन मीन। लुक, जो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है, वी हैव इन एन असिमेट्रिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन द अर्थमेटिक मीन एंड मीडियन आर रेस्पेक्टिवली 30 and 32, कैलकुलेट द मोड। वॉट इज गिवन इन द प्रॉब्लम देयर, इट्स गिवन देयर इन एन असिमेट्रिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, इट्स गिवन देयर इन असिमेट्रिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन अर्थमेटिक मीन एंड मीडियन, वी हैव गिवन अर्थमेटिक मीन एंड मीडियन, वी हैव गिवन अर्थमेटिक मीन एंड मीडियन आर रेस्पेक्टिवली 30 and 32। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अर्थमेटिक मीन, इट्स अबाउट अर्थमेटिक मीन मीन्स बेटा वी आर गोइंग टॉकिंग अबाउट आवर मीन। नाउ वी हैव गिवन मीन, वी हैव गिवन मीडियन, वी हैव टू बी कैलकुलेट मोड हियर, वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ मोड हियर। नाउ इट्स गिवन देयर, इट्स अ केस ऑफ असिमेट्रिकल, इन असिमेट्रिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, व्हेन आवर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज नॉट असिमेट्रिक, then we have given our mean is 30, our median is 32, then we have to find to calculate mode here. Now what is the relationship between the mode and mean and median is what? Mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean, mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean. What is our median? It's a 32, 3 times 32 minus 2 times, what is our mean? Mean is 30 given there. And now what we have, 3 into 32, it's 96 minus 60, then our mode is what, it's a, we get our mode is 36. What is our mode there? It's a 36, we get our, I mean, have a given our values there, it's a given there, in a symmetrical distribution, the arithmetic mean and median are respectively 30, mean is 30 and median r is 32. Then what is, we have used the formula, what is mode, is we have to calculate mode, mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean, then we get the value 3 median minus 2 mean, then we get 326, 339, 96, 2 into 30 is then 60, then it's 6 minus 0, 0, 96. Then our mode is what, it's a 36 there. Now look, we are going to find out, we are going to take the next problem to explain you. Again, in a moderately distribution, In a moderatory, sorry, it's in moderatory asymmetrical distribution, the mode and mean are 32.1. It's given the mode and mean. Again, this is given in our asymmetrical distribution. Our mode and mean, what is given there? The value of mode is 32.1. And the value of mean is given there, 35.4. Then we have to calculate here our median. We have to find out median there. Again, what is our formula? Mode is equal to 3 median minus 2 mean. Then what we are on the median. Then our 3 median is given by mode plus 2 mean. Then our median is given by 1 by 3 mean plus 2 by 3. Sorry, it's a mode, not mean. Then our it's a median given by 1 by 3 of mode plus 2 by 3 of look, can we can see here our median is our lies between our mode and mean there in the midwise there. And now look, we are going to put the values there. 1 by 3 of mode, what is the value of mode? It's at 32.1 plus 2 by 3, what is the value of mean there? It's a 35.4. Then we are going to solve it. Now look, it's we have 313 and 0. 3721 plus it's a 2 into 313 and 0.8. Now our median is what? Given by 10.7 plus 2816 carry 1, 21213 and 212. Then it's a 7 and 6, it's a 0.3 carry and 1. Then our median is given by 34.3. It's our given by 34.3. Look, what is given there? We have given the values there. Mode is our 32.5, mean is 35.4. We have to calculate median. Then we have a recessive mode. Our mode is given by 3 median minus 2 mean. Then our we can write down 3 medians equal to mode plus 2 mean. Then we get median is equal to 1 by 3 mode plus 2 by 3 mean. Then we are going to put the values there, and so after solving our median is what? 10.7 plus 23.6 going to add it, then we get our the required value of median is what? It's a 34.3. What we get? It's a 34.3. Now look, take another question on the empirical formula here. Again, in a given there, in a moderately skewed distribution, the value of mode is 120. The value of mode is 120. It's given there, the value of mode is what? It's a 120. It's a what? 120. And that of median is 140. And that of median is 140. Then that of mean, find the value of arithmetic mean. Then find the value of arithmetic mean, means we have to calculate here mean. Again, we are going to solve by using our empirical formula. We know that what is our empirical formula? What is the relationship between when the there is a asymmetrical frequency distribution? When our distribution is our frequency distribution is asymmetrical, then the empirical relationship between this among mode, median and mean is what given by, because we have three values, then it's a among the recent, it's what our mode is given by 3 times median minus 2 times mean. Now but here we have to calculate mean there.
Then what we have by this formula, 2 times mean is given by 3 median minus mode, or we are going to calculate mean is by what? 3 times median minus mode divided by 2. Now we are going to put the values there. 3 times, what is the value of median? It's a 140. Minus mode, what is the value of mode? It's a 120 divided by 2. Now what we get? It's a 300421. It's a what? It's a 420. 30, then of 3 4 12, 2 1 carry 1, 4 minus 120 upon 2. Then what we get? We get 300 divided by 2. Then what is the value of mean? 300 divided by 2 means it's a 150. The value of our mean is what? It's a 150. Look out. We have done our problems which are based on our empirical formula. Means what is the, we have the resistance among mean, mode and median there. We have seen what is the resistance among our mean, mode and median. Now and then we have seen how can we calculate if any two values or two center values are given there. Now then look, when I am going to be discuss a problem there, where we are going to be, till now we have discussed the problems whenever we have a, there is a unknown frequencies there, but we have not discussed any single questions when we have any three frequencies are missing there. And I am going to be explain you the problems where our three frequencies are missing there. Before I am going to be to take the problems where our three unknown frequencies are there, when we are going to find out our unknown frequency, then before look in our this given topic, the must thing is that what you have to be kept in your mind, that the must thing is that if there maybe two questions are arises there, first of that, what is the value of mean, mode and median when our frequency distribution is symmetrical there? Then you have to be kept in your mind that in the case when our frequency distribution is symmetrical, then the all three values of mode, median and mean are same there, are identical there. Our this empirical relationship, this is called our empirical relationship among our mean, mode, median. It happens only then when our the nature of our frequency distribution is what? It's asymmetrical or skewed there. Then you have to be kept in your mind that our empirical formula is just for a nature of the frequency distribution is what? It's asymmetrical or not symmetrical or skewed there. But when our frequency distribution is symmetrical there, then all the three values of this central values are identical there. Okay? Then now look, we are going to take a problem of when we have given any two values of measures of central tendency and there are some frequencies are missing there, then how can we get our three missing frequencies there? Then now look, we have a problem. Look, it's a given a problem. The median and mode of the following Bayes distributions are known to be. Here is given median modes, mode of the following Bayes distribution. We have given median. We have given mode there. We have given median, we have given mode there. Now, it's given there the value of median is what? 33.5. The value of median is given 33.5 and the value of mode is given there rupees 34. Then we have given a frequency table there. In our frequency table, it's given. We have wages in rupees and number of persons there. We have wages in rupees and number of persons there. In wages, we have 0, 10, 10, 20. We have about 0 to 10, 10 to 20.
20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70.
0, 10, 10, 20, 20, 30, 30, 40, 40, 50, 50, 60, 60, 70. And number of persons are 4, 16.
F1, F2, F3.
And then last we have 6 and 4.
It's a 6 and then last is 4. And total is given there. What is our total of frequencies? It's given there. 230.
It's given there 230. Now look, we in this problem we have a given up basis of some number of person there between 0 to 10. There are four persons doing a job between the rupees in 0 to 10. In 10 to 20 there are 60 persons, and 20-30 we have to find out F1, F2. There are three missing frequency. We have to find the number of person in the our intervals 20, 30, 30, 40, and 40, 50 there. And look, how can we are going to be, find out the values of these unknown frequencies F1, F2 and F3. To get this, first of all, look, what we have given there? We have given median. Median is 33.5. Then what is our, we have given median there. Median is 33.5, means this is our median class. This is our median class. Also mode is 34. Now in the case of mode 34, look, again, we in this problem, we have our class interval is same for median as well as mode there. Before we are going to use the formula median and mode there. Look, we are just going to first of all find out the sum of frequencies. Look, 16 plus 4 20 plus 6 26 plus 4 30 means what we have? F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus 30 is equal to what? It's a 230 there. Then F1 plus F2 plus F3 is 230 minus 30, 200. Look, what do we have? We have the first our relationship between the sum of all three frequencies is what? It's about 200. Now, this is our equation one. Look, now we are going to calculate how. Let's give in that median. What is the formula of median? L plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into height of the median class. This is formula for to calculate median. Now look, it's given that our median is 33.5. Then we are going to put the here 33.5. And our what is your median class? It's a 30-40. Then our lower limit is what? It's a 30. We get our lower limit plus n by 2. The total is 230. Then half of 230 is what? It's a 115 minus CF. Look, this is our median class, and we have to the CF is what? Sum of the frequencies preceding to our median class. Then what we have? We get 16 plus 4 20 plus F1 means 20 plus F1. When you are going to put here CF 20 plus F1, then we have minus 20 minus F1 upon F frequency. F is what? It is a frequency of our median class. Then it's a value what? F is what? We have here for F2 and height is our 10. Height is our 10. Now look. We are going to solve it. After solving, we get the relationship between what? We are going to get a relationship in our between F1 and F2. Look, first of all, the 33.5 minus 30, what do we have? We have here 3.5, and here we get 150 minus 20 means 95. 95 minus F1. 95 minus. We have to take multiply with this 0, and we have 950 minus 10 F1 upon F2. Then after cross multiplication, doing cross multiplication, what we have? We have here 3.5 F2 plus 10 F1 is equal to 950. This is our equation number 2. What is our equation number 2? When we are going to use our cross multiplication, then what do we have? 3.5 F2 plus 10 F1 is equal to 950. This is our equation number 2. Then, now we have a median, we use the median, then also it's given there mode. It's given there mode there. What is the formula of mode? और मोड इज कैप्चर्ड बाई द वैल्यू ऑफ मोड इज गिवन 34 देयर एंड व्हाट इज द मोड फॉर्मूला इट्स अ एल प्लस एफ एम माइनस एफ एम माइनस वन अपॉन टू एफ एम माइनस एफ ऑफ एम माइनस वन माइनस एफ ऑफ एम प्लस वन इन टू अगेन विथ ऑफ द क्लास लुक अगेन आवर मीडियम क्लास एंड मोडर क्लास आर सेम इन द गिवन प्रॉब्लम देन द वैल्यू ऑफ एल इज वॉट 30 मोड इज आवर 34 सॉरी लुक व्हाट इज आवर एफ एम एफ एम इज आवर मोडर फ्रीक्वेंसी आवर एफ एम इज वॉट F2 and F minus 1 is our preceding frequency to the our motor class, then it's F1. 2 times F1 means we have 2 F2 minus F1 and our Fm plus 1 is what? It's F3 minus F1 minus F3 and width of the motor class is again 10 there. Then what do we have? 34 minus 30, we get 4 here. We get 4 is equal to 10F2 minus 10F1, then we have 2F2 minus F1 minus F3. Now we are going to be doing cross multiplication and going to get the values up here. We don't need up this formula here because we put the all values here. Now look what we have, it's a 4 to 8. And we are going to cross multiplication. We have 8F2 minus 4F1 minus 4F3 is equal to 10F2 minus 10F1. Now we are going to solve it. Then look, it's a positive there. 10F1 minus 4F1, then we have 6F1. And then we have minus 10F2 and plus 8f2, then we have minus 2f2 and minus 4f3 is equal to 0. Further, we can also solve it because we look at 2 is common there. Then, after taking common 2, then what we have 3f1 minus f2 minus 2f3 equal to 0. This is our equation number 3. Now look what we get the equations 3f1 minus f2 minus 2f3 equal to 0. What is our second equation? 3.5f2 plus 10f1 equal to 950. And first equation is what? We have f1 plus f2 plus f3 is equal to 200. Now look, we have three variables, and we have three equations there. It's up. We can solve it because we have three unknown values and we have three equations there. First of all, we have f1 plus f2 plus f3, 200. And here we have 3f1 minus f2 minus 2f3. These two equations are in the terms of f1, f2, f3. And our second equation is only terms of f2 and f1. Then we are from equation 3 and 1, we are going to eliminate our f3 to solve up our to get values here. Then we are going to be eliminate our f3. Then we have to eliminate f3. We have to multiply with this 2. Then we have 2f1 plus 2f2 plus 2f3 is equal to 400. Now we are going to eliminate our f3. Look what we have, 3 plus 2, we have 5f1 and 2f2 minus f2, then we have only f2 is equal to 400. Now from equation 3 and equation 1 prime, since we have multiplied with 2 our values there, we have what? We have 5 times f1 plus f2 equal to 400. And what do we have here? We have 3.f2 plus 10f1 equal to 950. Now we are going to solve our, we can take this equation number 4 and we have equation number 2. Look, in equation number 2 we have 10f1, then we are going to eliminate f1 there. Then also we can write down it. We can change this by multiply with 10. Look, I am just going to be delete this formula there because we don't need up this formula here. We have our equation there. Now look, we have 5f1 plus f2 equal to 400. Here we have 3.5f2 plus 10f1 equal to 950. Then we are going to make it this 10f1 multiply with 2. Then we have 10f1 plus 2f2 is equal to
5 to 10 plus 2 f2 equal to 800. This is our 4 prime. And our question 2 is what? 10 f1 plus 3.5 f2 is equal to 950. Now we have to eliminate this, then we have to subtract. After subtracting, what we have? We have eliminate our f1. Now minus 3.5 and 2, what we have? It's a minus 1.5 f2, and here we get 950. Then we get minus 150.
We are going to subtract 950 to 800, then we have 150.
Then 1.5 f2, then what we have? f2 is equal to 150 upon 1.5, that means it's a 100.
Now look, we get the value of our f2 is what? It's a 100. Now we are going to put the values. F2 is there in equation 4. Then we have 5 f1 plus 100 equal to 400. Then 400 minus 100 we have. Yes, we have 300 here. Then our the value of f1 is what? 300 upon 5. 5 6 30 0. Then we get the value of f1 is what? 60. We get the value of f1 60. We get the value of f2 100. Now we have f1 plus f2 plus f3 is what? 200. f1 is 60. Our f2 is what? 100 plus f3 is what? 200. Then 160. Then f3 is what? 200 minus 160. Then we get 40. Then we get the all values of unknown frequencies f1, f2 and f3. Then please revise all the problems and please get through it. What I am discussing today, our empirical relationship there. Then after that, practice the problem at your home. If anyone having any doubts in anywhere, then please ask me to my online classes there. Thanks to all.